And it's got a lot of space in my heart. And it allows me to tell the story of how I got hired on to this farm. I was driving through. You know, I've wound up in Cookstown. I was in the next town over, and somebody said, you gotta check out old man Keith's farm in Cookstown. I think he's looking for work, you know. And I drove up, and I drove into, I pulled my van into the, there's a farmhouse, and this big giant barn, and I walked into the barn, and he's in the middle of milking, and he says, what can I do for you? And I said, I heard you might need, some work around here done. And he said, as a matter of fact, I do. Now, I had been traveling for a long time, and I'd asked a lot of farmers if they were looking for help, and this was the first time I'd heard that, and so I was excited until the next sentence came, and he said, what kind of experience do you have? And I said, I've seen a cow before. And he said, it's going to take me 2 weeks to train you. I just might as well do it myself. Thanks anyways, but, good luck. Good luck to you. And I said, okay, thanks. And I walked off and I jumped in old gym and I drove on down the road. And I made it about a half mile down the road. And I said to myself, Frank, listen, man, you are on this epic journey, and you cannot walk away from this opportunity. He needs work. You're a hard worker. Give it another try, So I turned the van around and I drove back to the farm. Walked into the barn. He turns around, has kind of a puzzled look on his face. And I said, look, I understand that it's going to take a little while to train me. If you put me up, I'll work for the first week for free. And then after that week's up, you can decide whether or not I'm worthy of being hired. And he said, I gotta be stupid to pass that up. And so he said, all right, report for duty tomorrow. He didn't have me on the 3 a.m. milking yet. He said, he kind of tricked me into it. He said, report at 7 a.m. I'm like, 7 a.m., all right. And right from there, when he said, come back at 7 a.m., that's when I drove to Fitzy's and I had my first beer at Fitzy's. And so fast forward after my first day of working on the farm. This guy, I was a city boy, and I came in and I'd never been around cows before or farm before. That first day, that first week, he kicked my ass. And I was like figuring it out. Like, I didn't know how to touch a cow, I'd be in a pen with this calf that, it's a calf, but it's still, it still weighs, 250 pounds, And it's sitting there, bucking up against me. You gotta try and get the hay that peed all over and shat all over out of the pen. Like, I was trying to figure it all out, and he didn't give me a lot of instruction, And he worked me hard, and I remember after that first day, finished up at 5, and it had been raining during the day, and it was still drizzly, and it was gray afternoon, and they hadn't set up my room in the house yet, and so I was still sleeping in my van, so I was sitting on my van, the side doors were open like this, and I was sitting there with the guitar, and just thinking to myself, dude, what have you gotten? And the van was parked behind the barn, and it was facing the cow pasture, one of the cow pastures, And I just started playing, and I was playing this riff on the side of the instrument. I was just kind of sitting there and I was playing, and I was thinking about how crappy my day had been. And the weirdest thing happened is like this one cow, some pastor just kind of like, and just kind of like stood in front of the van, shot his cut, and that was my first audience.
I hope it wasn't
Nicole, really.
It was not Nicole. That would have been a plot twist. And I just, you know, I just figured this cow was kind of, you know, enjoying the tunes and sort of playing, and a couple more kind of wandered up. And so before I knew it, there was like just this little gathering, my little audience of cows, and so I wrote this song right there called The Cow Song. Like I said, not some of my greatest work, but we're going to play it anyway. Go. You got a strange way of saying hello. Your tail's swinging slow. And I wonder what's behind those dull stares. But I'm happy for the company, so I guess I don't really care. Who the hell ever know where this and that may go? But for now, I'm just kind of happy playing to the cow. Well, I never thought myself as the eccentric type, but since I got that label, well, I guess it's all right. And the hazy sunset slowly fades before my eyes, and I wonder what I'd be doing if under different skies. Who the hell ever knows where this and that may go? But for now, I'm just kind of happy playing to the cow. The skeeters away from this tired farming man, and as darkness creeps in, my eyesight slowly melts away, and the dazzling greens of the fields slowly turn to darker shades. Who the hell ever knows where this and that may go? But for now, I think that for now, well, shit, I'm just happy playing to the cow.